Now we are going to sketch a solution of this initial value problem. So the initial condition is y at 0 is 2, and this is an autonomous equation. So first thing to note in this case is that let's see that what are the stable solutions of or the equilibrium points of this differential equation. So you can notice that this function here, that becomes 0 when y is 0, or since natural log of 1 is 0, this when I take y equals negative 1, then the derivative of y with respect to t will be 0, and that will also be an equilibrium solution. So let's first go ahead and sketch these two solutions since we know them already. So here is our equilibrium solution y equals 0, and then we will draw this y equals negative 1. So these are the two equilibrium solutions here, okay, corresponding to the points where this function is 0. Now we would like to sketch a graph of the solution of this initial value problem where y at 0 is 2. So the first thing to notice would be this. The graph cannot cross the t-axis because of the uniqueness theorem. And at this point, let's not worry about, means let's not pay attention to the points of inflection. So what I'm going to do is this, that I'm going to sketch a graph here which will just go like this, passing through 0, 2. And I'm just going to bring in a computer sketched graph because my hands are now too old to sketch it properly here on the screen. So here is a sketch of this initial value problem. That is when y0 equals 2. All right, this is a graph, and here this y equals 0 and this graph appear to be meeting, but you know that they never meet here. It just goes asymptotically. All right. Now let's take up this question that we want to sketch the solution corresponding to this initial condition. That is y0 is negative 0.5. So you can see that negative 0.5 is between negative 1 and 0. And we can also notice this, that between these two values, this quantity is negative, right? So meaning thereby that dy dt is going to be negative. And because of that, what will happen? That the function y will be a decreasing function, okay? So let's go and try to sketch this portion here. So in this case, the solution will pass through this, and it's going to be decreasing all throughout. And we know this, that it cannot cross y equals 0 or y equals 1. So what we are going to do is this, that we shall just sketch the graph, okay? And it will come through here and go on decreasing, and will go asymptotically in this direction. So let me bring a graph for you here. So this is a computer generated graph of, and you can sketch it if I was doing it on, you know, by pencil, and if my hands were better than what they are now. So the graph will just be sketched like this, and an approximate graph is good enough, okay?